Hello everyone, my name is Aishwarya with my co-host Aditya.
And welcome to the Mobile UX Podcast, where we cover interesting UX technologies and communities.
So today we are talking about PWAs. What are PWAs? Why are they so popular? So Aditya, can you tell me what is the trend around these PWAs and what is the market around apps and websites?
The interest in PWAs peaked from the interest in mobile-first user experiences. And the reason people are really getting into that whole side of the web is because as of 2019, about 50% of online shopping was actually done from phones. So in the past, where websites have been made to run on desktop first, people are realizing that, hey, maybe we should be moving these websites to mobile and make them mobile ready. And with doing that, mobile obviously has its challenges that you don't naturally face on desktop, which is maybe sometimes you have spotty connection and your phone isn't as fast as your desktop. So to kind of answer that, Google and a lot of other companies have been pushing this technology called PWA, Progressive Web Apps. And so yeah, progressive web apps have a bunch of great features that we're going to be talking about today that help us enhance our experience, not just for e-commerce, which is what we're going to be talking about today, but for all websites in general.
So let's dive into a PWA, progressive web app. So the basic three pillars of progressive web app is that they give offline support, they install on your phone, and they have a mobile first approach.
Yeah, definitely. What's really great about this is this app-like experience, because e-commerce companies especially, which we're going to be focusing on today, there was this race, like this gold rush a few years ago, which was everybody needs an app on the App Store. What people started to realize is not everybody's going to download your e-commerce application just to like make one purchase of a pair of shoes. Like, people only download apps when they really need it.
Yes.
And actually there are studies by Google and published by Google that actually showed, I think, if you asked your customer before when they arrived at your site right away to go download your app, they actually 60% of them, or 70% of them, don't download your app and leave your website and never come back. So don't tell your user to go download your app. That's just how you drive away business. So PWA is definitely, that's the answer, where you can have an app in the browser, basically.
Yeah, it wasn't a very nice experience whenever I visit any website and a huge pop-up comes out and tells me to download it. And many a times I just close the tab because I just don't want to face that annoying UX or UI.
Yeah, so like at that point you're going to go to Amazon because they probably sell their product there, and Amazon's not going to tell me to download their app because I already have their app.
Yes.
And in this day and age where like people are deleting Facebook, there's fat chance that you're going to make it onto somebody's phone.
Correct. So PWA comes with this very powerful thing of supporting offline, and what used to be there in past, that whenever internet goes off from the device, either from laptop or desktop, the whole thing crashes down and you just stick on the page or a boring...
You just see like a bad browser offline screen.
Yes. In PWA, we have a much better support, and we can design what experience we want the user to have when he's offline.
Yeah, so this is a really this is where like the big wins of PWA really start to show up, which is, this all stems from this idea of, in the past we've been having our sites, like all of our sites are being rendered on the server and then being sent as a finished template to our phone. So that means as soon as you want anything new, your phone is completely dependent on you having an internet connection to the person who's hosting that website. With PWAs, the real change, the shift, the kind of the paradigm shift in technology is now the instruction set is being sent to the phone, and that instruction set is being executed on the phone.
Yes.
That means that when the phone realizes that it doesn't have internet connection, you can already have sent an instruction set of what to do in that offline situation. So that immediately gives you a grasp on what to do, and that can range from anything of just maybe a more beautiful error 404 page to some kind of interaction, because it's all finally just JavaScript that you can customize. You can create little games, maybe. Maybe you have like a little gallery that you, if you're on e-commerce, you could have like, oh, while you're offline, hey, check out this like spring collection that we've saved onto your phone in case of an offline scenario.
Yeah, it's also a benefit that nowadays the hardware are very good. And the person is really carrying a thing which is capable of managing a lot of things at a time.
Yeah, early on when PWA started, there was this whole like sentiment and kind of feeling by the tech community, obviously, because the common person doesn't know this, that like, oh, running JavaScript and PWAs on my phone is just going to kill my battery life. Because, well, let's face it, phones weren't really that like capable maybe just 5 years from now, 5 years ago from now. But really nowadays, it's your phone can just chew through that like it's no big deal.
Yes.
And another thing that I want to make sure like that people understand is like it's not just offline support. There's also, it's critical that your website loads fast. Because if it's not going to load fast, people have other places to be, other things to do. So by not waiting for the whole calculated page to come out onto your phone, which takes longer because the server has to do more work and then it has to send a much bigger file to you.
Yes.
It can send a much more compressed instruction set, and that loads sometimes less than a second, in less than a second. Whereas traditionally we've been looking at e-commerce websites that take upwards of 5 and maybe even 7 seconds.
Yes. So the another thing which PWA comes with is a support of its get install in your phone.
Yeah.
It promotes you like download, go download.
So what's nice about this, I see where you're going with this and how it can become kind of hypocritical, but saving it onto your phone can be a basic banner. It doesn't have to be like something where you make the person leave your website, go to the app store. It's just something that it's on your website, it's one click, and it without even leaving the website, it's on your phone now.
Yes. And next time you can just tap on that icon and use it as an app.
Yeah, and it actually takes up way less space than an app too. So people with less storage on their phone can not have to worry about that because it's finally just a website and it's no big deal. So after you've gotten your user to maybe save your app, your website on their home screen, most people now just perceive it because it's on their home screen. They perceive that no longer like a website, and they have expectations like an actual application. So maybe app-like, it now has to be more app because now a worse experience may cause a user to actually delete your website from their phone. And to do that, there's these great tools in web technologies. And there's a specific thing that we can define called display mode. And we can recognize when a user is launching our website from their home screen.
Yes.
And it's the reason that's so important is because when we're using our app from the home screen, we're not getting any of the browser, Chrome. So no tab switching, no back button, no URL bar, nothing. It's a clear, most people won't even be able to tell that they're using a PWA. People most likely will just think it's an actual application. What that means is a lot of websites are dependent on browser back buttons and stuff like that and opening new tabs. Like off frequently you will see in e-commerce sites when I click on a product, that product opens up in a new tab. Can't happen anymore. It has to be a connected flow. So recognizing that we're in a display mode that's been launched from the home screen means we can add UI elements to our app, to our PWA that only show up in that mode. So it'd be like a back button, certain kind of attributes like some kind of padding or spacing that would otherwise not be needed on browser. And just things like that that help the user when they're when they're launching your PWA from their home screen. Oftentimes maybe like a cancel button on your search that you wouldn't need on your browser. So just being mindful of these kind of things is very important. But also launching, because now you're in an app kind of, you're faking an app experience, you also have to fake the offline to a greater extent.
Yes.
So this entails a lot of caching. And caching is a very important part of PWA, but it can also be your Achilles heel when you do too much of it. don't do it correctly.
Mm.
I haven't personally done a lot of it, but Ashura, do you, maybe you have some more
Yeah.
knowledge around what the best way to do caching is, what caching looks like in Vue and stuff like that.
So in Vue storefront, we use Vuex, and it manages all the caching and local storage thing. And we can specify which details we want to load locally, so we can provide the offline experience. And very correctly said that we should not do so much of caching, because then it's messes with the processing speeds and the loading speed of the page. But it's a really great tool for giving a very good offline experience to your user.
So is there something that like commonly people there's like a common misconception that like people think they should be caching this but they actually shouldn't be? Is there anything like that? Maybe like don't save all of your product images to your person's phone because that's just gonna ruin your it's gonna crash your site.
In this, we should go with the approach of predictability clicks. And we can load a certain amount of product images which are already in the screen, and we can not worry about all the other product images which are later in the pagination. So this can be an approach which will give a quick user interaction and less load time. Also, it will save some space, and the person will not do a lot more caching.
Yeah, I know a common approach that we're taking, and I've seen some other sites take, is they only save the places you've been. So if you ever go back or if you've been to like a category page, they save all of that. And even sometimes to make that a little bit more lean and efficient, they only save one hero image. So they don't save all of the alternate images of the product. So you can get like a basic experience and not compromise like the performance of the site. So that's something that I've seen people do. So how is it possible to like what actually goes behind queuing up an order and connect like placing that order when you connect online? Like what goes behind that technology there?
So the basic thing is, here we have an engine service worker which take cares of all this thing, which detects that you are connected to internet or not. And if you are not connected to internet, it takes things in his hand, and then gives that set of instruction that server has already sent for the offline approach. That engine will be interacting and taking care of the loading of the page and storing and giving instructions or whatever the user has given as an input. And then whenever it will reconnect with the internet, so it will synchronize the things.
And while implementing PWAs, a lot of companies see this as like an opportunity to maybe rethink how they've been designing their website, which we kind of touched on earlier, is it's an opportunity to rethink how maybe you've picked up a theme for Shopify or something that was actually made to run on desktop better than it was to run on mobile because it was designed back in the day, and it's just this idea of mobile-first browsing is still being evangelized throughout the community. So when you're moving to PWA and kind of replatforming your e-commerce engine like that, it's a nice moment. It's like a freeing moment where you have the opportunity to move your experience to a mobile-first experience without like taking a hit on your business.
Because the thing is, we have a lot of space in desktop, and the mobile come with some limitations, like a limited space, then there's browser or their back button and other stuffs in the experience. So any website or any PWA at least should have this mobile first approach, because your website should work very perfectly on mobile, and then in the desktop you have many reliabilities, then you can decide in design.
Actually, there's a stat I was trying to remember just before we were talking about this, is actually bad mobile experiences have been related to or have been connected to up to 62% people leaving your website if they have one bad mobile experience, and they will once again never come back. So there's a lot of stuff like this, and we've covered a lot more stats related to this in our two blogs we've been referencing throughout this time, which is our blog for how to design a mobile first user experience, which is a great 10-15 minute read and just gives you all of the easy wins. And a lot of these mobile experiences don't have to be PWA. PWA is just a great excuse to do them. But these are things that people should be doing anyway. And then obviously we have our progressive web apps and how they're the future of e-commerce. So great stuff like this. One thing we haven't talked about for some reason yet is that PWAs offer push notifications on your device. This is an incredible piece of real estate that you get on your user's device, which is even when they're not on your website, you can give them the latest deals and stuff like this to keep them engaged and coming back to your website that a traditional website just cannot do.
Yeah, and this mobile first approach is very important for your SEO also, because Google only indexes your mobile website. And if you are missing any key information in that mobile first in the mobile website, then you are losing a lot of ranking in the Google
Actually,
indexes.
that's a good point. And I've actually seen that people sometimes accidentally do too much PWAing, JavaScripting of their website, where there's some content on your website that needs to be loaded up on the server. Because if it's not on the server, then Google can't go through, it's not going to go read your JavaScript and decode what that means. It needs plain HTML. So some kind of like SEO optimizations that you're doing. So if you have like key information that's necessary to get your rankings high on Google, make sure those are loaded up on the server side and not on the client side to make sure that Google is indexing that information.
So you need to be really smart around the whole PWA experience, what you need to put on server, what you want in the website, caching and everything.
That's, I guess, a combination of how PWAs are driving, like giving people a cutting edge on their websites and how it's a really big competitive edge for e-commerce websites and just good reasons why you should be using it. I think along with this, at some point, we should cover that technology called AMP, which is also a thing created by Google. It's also another thing for making your websites even faster. And I think maybe PWAs, but definitely if your website is AMP enabled, you get a big boost in like Google SEO rankings. And that wraps up our episode 6 today for AMP, for progressive web apps and what great things you should be doing with them. If you're looking to do PWA for your e-commerce site, we highly suggest Vue Storefront. I think it's the number one open source PWA
Framework,
project.
yes.
So definitely check that out. We're always in the Capybara community, so you might even run into us and Vue Storefront community. And thanks for watching today's episode and listening in.
Thank you.